Hello and welcome back to XCOM 2, Long War of the Chosen. My name is Saiken and we're playing Legendary Iron Man on this Beta 1 mod. First of all, apologies for missing an upload last week. I had some health issues and I couldn't essentially play. Needed to make a decision and health comes first. But now we're back and I am pretty sure that we can keep up with the pace. Anyways, back to the actual game. The last thing that happened was we are getting attacked once again up here. And we only have about 21 hours left to do that, which brings us to today's mission. We're going to expedite the infiltration. And many of you might have asked yourself, what's the intel at the end of the day used for? Why are you collecting it? Well, one thing that intel is used for is essentially boosting infiltration. So we're now spending 30 intel and we got the infiltration up to 126%, which is great. It's over infiltrated. We're only fighting against 7 to 9 enemies. Got a okay-ish squad plus another rookie. And the idea really is, let's try to launch or to make this mission as flawless as possible, because we need all of them in the mission to defend right afterwards. And we landed. Look at us, all pimped up. We need to download from right here. Luckily, we got 2 extra rounds from our resistance operations order, but we also got Dirk Peters, a complete and utter rookie. And don't get me wrong, I don't think that rookies are bad or anything, but we're kind of in the point in the game where a rookie, even with decent equipment, is not good enough. So what I want to do is, I want to use the high ground, but at the same time, essentially make sure that we're not missing a pack downstairs. Good. 9 turns might look like a lot, but it is not. So what we're going to do is, I really like to aggressively push forward. Mike Bravo is going to lead the team. Matter of fact, Mike is probably our damage dealer in this one with his heavy light machine gun. His heavy machine gun, of course. Anyways, we got a Shinobi and we got a Specialist. It's actually an okay team and we can use the Shinobi to kind of continue scouting out for us. Keep in mind, I think we still got the Dark Event with the Losts, so that's not over. Good, we need to get it up to here. Which kind of tells me we probably should use the full cover over here. And there's another high ground up here, which I think we can use to actually hack it. Keep in mind, 7 to 9 means we're at most up against 3 enemy packs. Done. Mike is moving in. Let's take the Shinobi. He has the best odds to not be spotted out. Alright, first pack. Pack of 2. We're putting our rookie in half cover. This spot here is reserved for Mike.
Copy that.
And we're blocking the entrance to the rooftop. I don't want to go there with Mike yet. We're staying in fully hidden in cover. Might be another pack that we're triggering. Okay, We definitely need to start fighting from here. It's very unlikely that we're essentially going through the rest of the map without without doing so. And we got 7 more turns, so time is looking plenty. Let's position ourselves correctly, shall we? Rookie moves forward. Spots out the team. Okay, that's good. Now, if we move Mike over here, I'm thinking about laying an Overwatch trap, actually. Yeah, I think that's the right play. Solid copy. I'm just hoping we're not triggering another pack back here. Okay, perfect. That worked out. Confirmed. Moving to here. And I mean, we can open with a grenade. Why not? Grenade will be pretty loud, so a lot of enemies will hear the explosion. But at the same time, it'll also shred quite a bit. Yeah, matter of fact, it will shred the shield bearer completely. I think it's not a bad idea. Specifically since I wouldn't know when we're going to use the grenade instead. Okay, let's take a look at our chances and the actual damage that we're going to deal. 90%, and we might be able to one-shot this guy. There's a good chance for crit as well. Mind you, Overwatch shots will not crit. That's a bit the problem. It's 100% chance. Pretty solid normal damage. And we're looking at what? Another 80% chance. Okay, so I'm assuming that with a grenade we would deal 4, 5, and 8 points of damage. Plus the grenade, if applied in the right order, it would be a kill for both of them. Moving in. They found us. Got Advent here. And I'm not 100% sure why we got revealed. Because that tile was not up for reveal. Oh, look at you, a hidden drop. Well, as so often in life, things are turning out to be quite different than you would have expected initially. All right, great. Awesome. Awesome. Okay, we probably can shut down the drone. We're most likely going to pull yet another pack. 100% chance to shut it down. I think we're going to do that. It's just the safest play. Good, this here. No, I want the center on top of him. Okay, so this here will shred him and possibly also remove the cover. It did exactly that. Nope. Let's focus on him and see if we can actually kill him. Of course, one damage shy of killing it. Going haywire. I feel tricked. It just told me that it's 100% shut down. Anyways, that worked out well. I'm not going to see about the drone next round. And that seals the deal. We're down to one enemy. Alright, only half cover. He's too far away to throw a grenade. And there we go. More enemies. Okay. We know there's another pack back here. And so far we have seen six enemies, which means there's definitely another pack somewhere else. First things first. If we were to attack him, I think that's not a bad idea. We should do it right away. We're ending in full cover, and even if we're pulling another pack, we still have enough turns to deal with it. He's in full cover, and I fear that we're not going to be able to hit him. Like, the chances to hit him are slim. It's a lot of 50-50s, and I need the actions to deal with the drones. I'm okay with pulling another pack as long as he's not pulling two additional packs. And this here might as well be a kill. A little bit over 35% chance to actually kill him.
Did you see that one?
Good. That took care of a very nasty problem. I think our position here generally is fine. So let's reload, Mike, and get rid of the drone. Perfect. Dirk here will not have, the rookie here, Peters, will not have a better shot even if he kind of comes closer. So instead, let's reload. Unfortunately, only a partial hit. But this here is armor penetrate. These here are armor penetrating rounds, so. Almost. Good, there's the next pack. All right, that's a bit more of a problem than I initially thought. Okay, well, we still got plenty of time. Let's move from one full cover to another full cover, because I think we will need the full cover.
That's it. Burning through ammo fast.
We can suppress one of them and attack the other one. Difficult decision. We could either go into full cover, which I think is the right call here, or we're taking the high ground. The rookie has a problem of hitting targets, which actually is a bit of an issue. Hmm. having no more full cover spot left over. I like the idea of having him in full cover. You know what? We don't need full cover in order to suppress. Which means we can simply go to here and still continue with it. Yeah, I think that's a good idea. All right. Into full cover we go. And let's see if we can hit this guy, because if we could hit him, we could have charged in and actually killed him. It's unfortunately not possible anymore. Again, moving into full cover. Unfortunately, we can't hit both of them with our flashbang, so I would resort back to suppression. And I don't want to charge in yet. Which means we're just grabbing the loot.
What am I doing with this?
And moving into full cover. Alright, most likely not the best way that round could have been played. We were a bit unlucky, and that is very unlucky, because now we have an injured soldier. Our support will not be able to join the next mission. That is definitely not good. I was hoping that wouldn't happen. Healing ourselves. All right, moving into a flanking position. We still got four more turns. We also need to start moving to the target, to be honest. Pretty solid hit overall. Again, moving into a flanking position. And the rookie got a kill. Good job. I really don't want to take the 30% shot. On the other hand, we can't really suppress him. With his armor, that's not going to be good enough. His armor is really a problem for us. You know what? We're overwatching. Full cover. And this here should get rid of at least his protection. Plus, since he's flanked, he needs to move. And that again will trigger the Overwatch. Won't kill him. But we maximized our chances of actually hitting him. Nice, that was only the protection. Okay, three more turns. We gotta move, and we gotta move a lot. Ready to rock. Taking a 50-50. Our rookie can stand back. Didn't work out. Only a 30% chance for Mike. We gotta get him into a better position. So I'm putting Mike into half cover a little bit closer to provoke that he's hopefully going to be the target. I'm not going to take the 26% shot. Or not. Difficult decision. I want to move over here because we're running low on time. And I think I want to run over here. But that may trigger another pack. Reloading. Such a low chance. All right. Minimizing the chance of him hitting us. And standing in the open is certainly not a advisable idea. But it will also make him run. Hardly did anything. We can't overwatch, we need to move closer. I'm trusting you here. Nah, that wasn't a smart play. Reinforcements are coming in soon. You can see the issue with enemies and too much armor if you don't have means to get rid of it. It's kind of a lose-lose situation, really. We could suppress him to get rid of the Overwatch. Best chances are coincidentally with our rookie. Still try the 50-50s before we suppress. Didn't work out. Alright, suppression removes his Overwatch. Trying to hit something above the minimal threshold damage. Yeah. You know, this is an incredibly risky move. You see, there's such a high chance that we're triggering another another pack. Besides, by the way. Should have pulled in the evac a lot earlier. That's fine. Better now than never. We're going to have one wave of reinforcements, and this here is a really, really desperate play attempt. He shoots into half cover, which is good. Alright, slash missed. 99% slash missed. Okay. This year might trigger another pack. It does not. Okay, perfect. Oh yeah, we want supplies. Yes, please. Of course. 20 supplies is too much to ask for. Okay, we'll continue to suppress him. Another 50-50, that didn't work out. Too bad. Reloading, and let's suppress him. Okay, perfect. He ran away, which also tells us that the last pack is somewhere in this direction. Get a little toasty here. Okay. Did we just start burning? I call bullshit. All right, not exactly sure where the enemy reinforcements are going to join us, but we can simply withdraw to the top of our roof and increase the chances of us actually hitting stuff. All right, rookie moves into full cover. Mike moves into full cover with an option to overwatch. Yeah, this here is bullshit to receive burning. Anyways, we're going to hunker down so that the burning is not going to result in any damage. We're overwatching twice, and let's see what the reinforcements are going to be made of. Interesting. They did not drop in direct line of sight. What? We just hunkered down, for fuck's sake. Sometimes I hate the game. We needed people without injuries. Done. And the game does like everything in its power to prevent that from happening. So we got two injured operatives. Alright, we're fully overwatching. I don't know why the hunkering down isn't removing the burning. It should. This is clearly a mistake. Yeah, He continues to burn, although I'm hunkering down. Oh my gosh. And yeah. This is fabulous. I couldn't write a screenplay more ignorant than that one. Okay, at least the burning stopped. Overwatch, Overwatch, Mike reloads and overwatches. I don't think we're alone out here. Nice. Good job. Are you telling me? Okay. The game is telling me we still have a hunkered down operative because he refuses to leave. Let's at least kill this guy. Good. Reinforcements are done. We're continuing to overwatch just until our specialist finally gets his shit together. Something is odd. Soldiers are not panicked two rounds in a row. And we certainly don't want to be here when the next pack of reinforcements are going to join us. Yeah, I'm semi-okay with how I played this mission. There were a couple of, like, moves which could have been done better. Specifically, how we've dealt with the shield bearer. One clear disadvantage of this team is it had only very limited means to deal with armor. And once they were in full cover, the ranks of the soldiers were too low to deal with shooting into full cover, and we had only very limited cover removal. So that clearly was an issue. But on the other hand, despite me not playing fully optimal, I just need to add that this mission here highlighted so much of the bullshit. Hidden drone that didn't move, so no movement indicators that spots us out and prevents a concealment trap. Random fire starting without even the necessity to do so, igniting us. Inability to remove fire chain fear, although that wasn't even necessary. So there was a lot of typical bullshit that has happened in this mission. Not particularly happy with the outcome. And here we go. Yeah, we got two wounded soldiers, so that's not going to work out, but we at least got three promotions. Nice. The soldier became an infantry, and look at that, he's also gifted, which means a lot of combat points. Ability points. Mike Bravo got his promotion. I love chain shot. I also like demolition, but I think we're going to go with chain shot on this one here. It's too good. That's actually not a bad ability. That's not a bad ability at all, specifically for later enemies such as Sectopods. That's also a good ability. That's also a good ability. And that's also a good ability. Mike got the nice abilities. Mike got the nice abilities. You know what? There you go, Mike. Gave you one of our XCOM ability pools. And that's a nice little damage boost. Our specialist definitely wants to have a medical protocol. That's not bad. I like it, but he's barely using grenades. We'll probably wait until chain shot. Fortify is awesome. And I like the full kit as well. Damn good ground might be something to consider, because I'm often finding myself having him on high ground. Let's take that. I like it. It's such a good extra bonus. Yeah, we got a lot of decent loot out of it. The problem that I'm seeing is we're probably not having enough soldiers for the next mission. That's really a problem. That is really a problem. We might need to abort some of the other infiltrations. Or go in with four soldiers. We got like Mike, a Shinobi, a Ranger, and a Grenadier squaddy. Can we free up anyone else? Because I'm not 100% sure if this here is going to be enough firepower for us to protect the data tab. Let's check one thing, because the assault in Quebec is almost done. Do I want to play the mission at right now? Kind of spending another 30 intel, because this team here could easily handle the other mission, the protect the data tab mission. But it's swarming enemy levels at the moment, so this is going to be a cluster F. It's difficult, guys. It's actually a difficult decision. If we were to boost it, it would go down to 30 enemies, and that's probably as low as I can get it. Because even if we infiltrate up to 200%, it's just a marginal difference. You want to hit the 100% mark at those missions, really. So that would be another 30 intel down the drain. But we get an intel package as well, and we probably get a lot of loot, so I'm not too worried about the last mission that we just did. Also gave us intel, so we're kind of net zero. Let's double check. Yeah, we really didn't lose any intel whatsoever Because the last mission gave us exactly the amount of intel. Okay, let me think about it, and you're going to see in the next episode what the decision finally has come to. It's going to be fun. I am leaning towards assaulting Quebec and paying the aliens a damn visit to finally liberate our North African area. That's going to be a large mission, so probably more than one part to watch that mission. Anyways, you know the drill. Thank you so much for watching this episode. Thanks for all of the comments that I'm regularly getting. Leave a like or a comment down below, and see you in the next episode. Bye bye.